I was out shopping at the thrift store today when I came across this iHome clock radio iPod dock. Normally I wouldn't pay any attention to these because I don't have any iPod or anything that would be compatible with that dock there, but I remember seeing a video by YouTube user Stereo Dust Particles about a similar iHome clock radio. I think his is a slightly newer model, but this one is pretty similar. It's the iH5. And I remember the one he reviewed had very nice sound through its built-in speakers and had pretty good reception. So I decided to pick this one up. It was only $5. It's slightly yellowed. You can see the color is supposed to be right there. It's supposed to be just white, but it faded to an off-white color. But it's not too bad. And the buttons light up. And this display is supposed to light up, but it's not really working that well. Sometimes it flashes, but most of the time it doesn't really show up. I did not get it with the power supply, so I'm just using a 12-volt power supply I had on hand. It's supposed to be designed for 15 volts, but it works just fine on 12 volts. Also did not come with the AM loop antenna, but I happen to have one that plugged in and works fine. It's actually from Sharp, and it has an attached FM wire antenna. But right now I'm receiving AM 740 from Toronto, Ontario, Canada. This has very good AM reception, and it's also pretty good on FM. Get dials on the top here for volume and the tuning, and it says set, so that may be for setting the clock as well. And you get controls for playing your iPod once you plug it in, some alarm settings, and I believe the iPod button also works with the line input on the back. On the back you can see the two base ports of the speakers. There's the DC power input, a line output jack, a couple buttons here for adjusting the clock, and the sleep volume, a DST setting for the clock because it has a time zone setting, and a line input. There's the connection for the AM loop antenna and the attached FM antenna. And underneath you can see is the iHome model iH5. Runs on 15 volts, 1100 milliamps. Made in China, of course. Manufactured and serviced by SDI Technologies Incorporated. There's a little door here for the backup battery, which surprisingly is not a 9-volt battery. It takes two AA's, and it came with these Berkeley and Jensen batteries, which I've never heard of, and of course they're dead. At least they haven't leaked. There's the little speaker grill with the alarm beeper. There was another one of these on the shelf, the same exact model, except it wasn't branded as iHome. It was branded as Cypress Bioscience, and it was silver instead of white, but it was $5 more, so I decided to get this one, even though it's a little bit yellowed. I don't mind as long as it works. Now I'm powering it with this Altec Lansing 15 volt power supply from a pair of computer speakers, just to see if the extra voltage would get the backlight to light up brighter, and it does not. The backlight is working, but it's very dim, probably even too dim for the camera to pick up. And this is a perfect demonstration of the difference a power supply can make in your AM reception. This KTEC 12-volt power supply was picking up all sorts of AM stations with absolutely no interference, but now this Altec Lansing power supply it sounds like an old tube radio of bad capacitors. There's so much buzzing. So obviously this power supply is not nearly as well filtered as this one is. I switched back to the other power supply, and now we have perfect AM reception again.
Some of us eat kubasa, some of us poutine, but we have traditions that help us stick together. Our milk comes in a bag, and mosquitoes eat at leisure. Playing in a snow suit, the true north strong and free. Hockey night on Saturday, there on CBC.
Oh, no,
in Canada.
That's 800 CKLW with a little ode there to Canada. And it looks like the backlight just came on. There it is on FM. It sounds kind of tinny on FM. I think it actually sounds better on AM because it kind of balances out better between bass and treble. Since this does have a line level input, I decided to test it with something completely inappropriate, like an 8-track player. Sounds like it's playing a little bit too fast. Because normally Anne Murray isn't that quite that high pitched. It would be nice if this thing had a tone control, but unfortunately it does not appear to have any. But the night will sure be colder and I'm bluer than blue, sadder than sad. You're the only light this empty room has ever had. Life without you. So that's the iHome iH5 iPod dock clock radio. I don't have any iPod to test it with. I do have an iPod, but it wouldn't be compatible with that connector. But I think even if you don't have anything to fit this iPod dock, it's still pretty good as a clock radio. So definitely worth picking up if you can get one for $5 like I did. That's good bass for these little speakers, especially considering that we're listening to AM radio. Crazy about that girl, how she got so much soul. I said she got the kind of love. I tested the batteries that were in it, and one of these Berkeley and Jensen batteries had gone so bad it was actually making reverse voltage. But the other one was perfectly fine, so I kept it in place here and I just put another new battery in here. So can any battery chemist out there explain why that happens sometimes? when a device has two batteries and instead of both of them discharging equally, one of them goes completely dead while the other one is perfectly fine. Now you can see even with nothing plugged in the power input, it's showing the clock display.
Radio AM 740 and 96.7 FM in downtown Toronto. This is the 9 o'clock mix of 60s, 70s, 80s. Roy Orbison and his number one song, Not Pretty Woman, Oh Pretty Woman, 1964. I'm Robbie Lane. I'm playing the tunes for you. We got the Guess Who, Tommy James, and the Shondells, Frankie Valli on his own, and lots more. This one from the movie, Butch Cassidy and the Sundance Kid, Raindrops.
Raindrops are falling on my head. Just like the guy whose feet are too big for his bed, nothing seems to fit. Those raindrops are falling on my head. They keep falling.